In this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, the Blue Hose tangle with the SoCon defending champion. And boy, they're an outstanding team. We're going to talk about that matchup, have a visit with coach, take a look at the highlights. We're also going to talk about the opponent that we kicked off the season with because they made some news as well. All that and more in this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football.
Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
We welcome you to this edition of Inside Blue Hose Football, along with the coach, Harold Nichols. I'm Eric Thacker. Thank you for spending this Saturday with us. Well, coach, we went up against the SoCon defending champion, and there's no doubt about it. Chattanooga is for real, and they were the favorite to win the SoCon, and they probably will do that, and they may make a threat deep in those FCS playoffs.
Yeah, I think, you know, going into the game, we knew the quality of the opponent we were going to play on the road at their place. You know, they've got a nice new facility that they built there in downtown. And credit goes to Coach Huseman and his football team. Mm-hmm. Outstanding. You know, they're good offensively. They can run the football. Defensively, their front seven is as good as we faced. They just do a really, really good job of playing good, sound football. Now, for us, you know, I don't think that we're playing the way that we're capable of playing. I really don't.
Okay.
Defensively, you know, we gave up way too many big plays. Mm-hmm. You know, it was kind of out of character for us. Offensively, we struggled. I think we had 8-3 and outs on the day, mm-hmm. punted way too many times. Just not giving ourselves a chance. And then, you know, you turn the ball over in the red zone going in down there, and that's just not good football. And we've got to be better than that. And although Chattanooga's a good quality football team, knew it would be a tall task going on the road and playing against them, we've got to get better as a football team, and you know, that's going to be our focus for this week.
All righty, Coach, what can you take out of a game like that?
Well, I think playing really good football teams like we have these first 2 weeks exposes your weaknesses. It does, you know, more so than if
puts
you were
more of a magnification
sure it does.
On it.
There's no doubt, because now we know we need to work on. There's no doubt about it. And, you know, we have got to be clicking on all cylinders. We've got to be a focused football team. We've got to be able to pay attention to the detail of our assignment better. And once we're able to do those things, if we start clicking that way and be able to get in a mode where we're executing on both sides of the football, I think we'll be a much better improved football team. But again, you know, some of it's us, a lot of it is who we played. Mm-hmm. I can't give Chattanooga enough credit. They're a really good football team. And like you said, I think, you know, that's a team that's going to go deep into the FCS playoffs. They're going to be a handful for a lot of teams this year.
Let's go back to week one and expand on that for a mm-hmm. second, because the fans really need to know about the opposition that we faced. Look at the news that the Chippewas made going down and defeating Oklahoma State. And throw out that last play, whatever. It was still, you know, they outplayed them there in Stillwater.
Yeah, great ball game. You know, I Central Michigan's preseason MAC favorite. They've got they've got an NFL quarterback playing for them. You know, and for them to go to Oklahoma State and go toe-to-toe with those guys and come out with a victory, I know there was a lot of controversy at the end of that game with the penalty that was called, but, it just goes to show you the quality of opponent that we've had these first 2 weeks. You know, it is what it is. We embrace the schedule that we've got and, make no excuses for it. We've got to play better, and we've got to be able to compete better, and that's what we're going to do.
And with that, the fact that the kids competed hard, mm-hmm. despite the outcome on mm-hmm. the scoreboard. Yeah. I know there's things we need to improve mm-hmm. on, like you said. Mm-hmm. I'll use one of your verbiages, football character again. Mm-hmm. So there's an opportunity for them to get better because they're willing to be coachable and willing to play hard, right?
Yeah, I think you hit the nail on the head right there. I think it's a matter of, it's not an attitude or an effort thing. It's not with our kids.
Right.
I think, you know, they'll compete and they'll come out and play and until the final horn blows. I mean, you know, and we'll have football character. But we've got to execute better, you know. Right. And in order to, you know, win football games in our league down the stretch here, we've got to get better, no doubt about it.
Well, let us go ahead and dive in, take a look at the offensive highlights first, the Mocs and the Blue Hose.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
All right, here we have our offensive highlights. Got a little boot play and, you know, get a little pass out to Zola Davis. Zola had a really, really good day. He had some big plays in the game. You know, we played him some at the setback position for us, the up back, and able to move him around a little bit. We got to find more ways to get him the football because he's a big athlete that can make some plays, and he did a nice job there with Zola there. Got Zola back in the game now. We're in a twins set to the field. We're going to run a little zone play right there. There's Darryl Bridges. You know, I wish we could have got him going a little bit more. He had a decent day, rushing for close to 90 yards, I guess, against a really good Chattanooga defense. But that's a nice job by the right side right there with Risto and those guys getting a hole for him. Here we've got a trip set. We're running a little inside zone play. You'll see Jarius Duncan in there at left guard making his first start. Run a little trap and get Darryl up inside for a good gain. We're in an empty set here. You see Will Brock, I think, in at quarterback here. Brought in Will late and makes a nice throw out to Kyle Goddard and get a nice first down here. I thought Will did a nice job coming in there and directing the offense and made some good throws, made some good decisions. Got Joe Kelly in the game in there at left guard. Eli Teeslink in there at center some, trying to create some depth on the offensive line, and thought those guys went in there and competed well. But you can see Will stepping up, making a nice throw, nice catch by Kyle Goddard right there, and got a first down. Here we are, we've got kind of a twin set right here, and you're going to see Darquez Watson make a really nice catch right there, one-handed catch over the top, and get a defensive pass interference on the defense here, but Will kind of stands tall in the pocket, delivers a nice throw, gives Darquez a chance to go up and make it. You know, we need guys make more plays like that down the field for us. Got Zola in there at tailback, and you'll see really get the ball here from the center. Kind of stand tall in the pocket right there. Got a little twist on by the defensive line, and nice throw and catch right there by Darquez. And that's our offensive highlights.
Coach, there's something else we need to talk about, is that the front line had to make some changes because Zach Cooper, the starting center, was out due to a concussion. Hence, you had to move left guard to center, et cetera. Mm-hmm. So new faces there, going up against one of the best front sevens in FCS.
Yeah, that was a little bit difficult. You know, you lose your center. You know, Zach is such a good player and kind of our leader up front, making all the calls and everything. We moved Zach Darst in there to center and played Jarius Duncan at left guard. You know, so we had some moving parts up front. And so hopefully we'll get Zach back and get him back in the fold. And like I say, trying to create some depth up front on the offensive line. You know, injuries are something that happen, and you got to have a next man up mentality, and that's what we did.
And homecoming for Darryl Bridges, and an outstanding performance. Yeah, he didn't hit the century mark, but the game, the way it unfolded, he really didn't get a chance to have more carries. But as we saw in those highlights, this guy has good vision, and he finishes his runs. That's what I like. He'll put his shoulder down, and he'll attack the defender.
Yeah, Darryl's a good back, you know. And like I say, you know, he was excited about going back home and had a lot of friends and family at the game. And, you know, I just wish that we could have got him the win. And but, you know, he did play well, and he's a complete back. And, you know, if we're going to continue to have some success on offense, we're going to have to get him going and open some holes for him.
Yeah, no doubt. Chattanooga's head coach, Coach Huseman, really likes Darryl Bridges. It was a good homecoming for him. Let us go ahead and take a timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at the defensive highlights. And Chattanooga got a taste of that defense early in the ballgame. Stay tuned.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Bojangles. It's Bow Time. and by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer.
Watching a cow.
Oh, what's it doing?
Impressions.
Power up your morning with a new 300-calorie egg white grill. Only at Chick-fil-A.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football. Now it's time to take a look at the defense. And again, at times during the game, boy, they really hit Chattanooga hard.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Here's a defensive highlights. They're kind of in a no-back look right here. Multiple formations they gave us all day long. Derek Crane, their tailback down here in the slots, a really, really good player, number 34, very versatile guy. They've got a lot of speed on the offensive side of the football. Solid up front, but we get a little blitz right here. And I thought Kyrie Rozier played one of his better games. He had a lot of, I think he had 3 or 4 tackles for loss, had 2 sacks. Tried to give him a little different look, confuse their protections a little bit, especially when they're in no backs here. And so credit goes to our defensive staff there, putting together a good plan right here, try to get some pressure on their quarterback, Benefield, who's very tall, athletic kid that makes a lot of plays with his legs. And here's Kyrie right there doing a nice job and getting the big tackle for loss on the first drive. Here they are in just a double set. You'll see big play right there by Brian Washington fitting up the back. And then you'll see Jordan Guyton, Grant Bidell in there at linebacker. There's Obina Tasawe and Cameron Mack in there stuffing that middle right there and making a nice tackle. Here we got, they got a little pistol set right there, doing a nice job, fitting the run. And we thought that was really important. There's Jordan Guyton and Malik Ketchins in there at linebacker, Derek Washington in there at defensive tackle, Obina Tasawe, and there's Derek getting some penetration, Ryan Brown setting a point. That was such an important part of defensive line play, is setting a point on defense. You get split backs here, run a little play action pass, and there's Kenny Coleman doing a nice job defending the vertical. And I think Kenny's played solid these first 2 ball games, and against some pretty good receivers. You know, they that have got some height and some speed to them. There's Kenny not giving up and doing a nice job knocking the ball away right there at the end. Here they're in a trips formation in the gun. I think we got some pressure dialed up. Brian Washington, and there's Steve coming off of his coverage right there and making a nice play out in the open field. Again, like I say, you know, really impressed with their quarterback. Did a nice job. Brian Washington trying to keep contained right there, and Steve coming up and finishing up, and that's our defensive highlights. Here's our special teams highlights, and Tim Hartshorn continues to do a good job at kickoff. I wish I could get him out there more so he can kick off more, but we're going to have to score some more points if that's going to be the case. But done a really nice job and is really hitting the ball well right now, and that's a big weapon to have at kicker.
Sure is.
To be able to kick the ball in the end zone, take pressure off of the kickoff team. And then, like you mentioned earlier, you know, Brett Norton, you know, he's really come on and has done a nice job. I think he had four punts over 50 yards on the day.
That?
Two of them at 60. And really did a good job of flipping the field. You know, I think he kicked six balls inside the 20-yard line.
That's correct. Mm-hmm.
You know, so for him, I think that, you know, him being a weapon like that, being the punter, and then obviously being able to put the ball through the uprights, being the extra point field goal kickers, you know, is quite a weapon to have. We try to get him some different looks punt-wise and, you know, trying to help ourselves some protection. And but Brett does a nice job here on a little coffin corner deal, a little pooch punt we got, knocks the ball down there to 4 or 5 yard line. Nice job by him. So, you know, that's winning football. That's good football right there, you know, being able to pin the opponent down inside their 20-yard line here. Nice job right there by Brett Norton, and you can see the kick we get and puts the ball down at the 4 or the 5. And those are our special teams highlights.
A couple of things real quick. The Mocs did not convert a third down. They were 0 for 13 or something like that. And then on fourth down and short, respect for the Blue Hose, especially what they were able to do last year, stopping people on fourth down. They were at midfield, so a couple of wins there for the defense. Special teams doesn't miss a beat. One of our favorite segments of the show is our Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. Nichols Automotive, your one-stop auto repair shop.
And here's this week's Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week, and there's Kyrie Rozier with the big sack on Benefield. Big tackle for loss right there on second down. See a little end zone shot of it here. You'll see Kyrie Rozier come off the side right there. And trying to get a play change from the sideline. Again, credit goes to our defensive staff for dialing up the pressure right here and freeing up Kyrie Rozier for this week's edition of Nichols Automotive Collision of the Week. Here's Kyrie in his stance. Ball snapped. You'll see Kyrie come off the edge. Big sack right there on Benefield. And that's this week's Collision of the Week.
Love that front line pressure of the Blue Hose. Now let's go ahead and transition to Coach's Corner.
Coach's Corner is brought to you by Jeff Smith, Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Allstate and Jeff Smith.
Welcome to this week's edition of Coach's Corner. We're going to take a look back at last week's game against Central Michigan. We've got a defensive play here with the Blue Hose with our backs against the wall here down in the red zone. Central Michigan has a kind of a closed formation. They've got two tight ends, and you can see the three backs in the backfield here. I want to say this is a second down play. They're going to run some play action pass to the right. I think that you'll notice Rock Yassin, who's the cornerback right there on the E, has got a run pass read here on the tight end. And you'll see the really good quarterback Cooper Rush for Central Michigan will fake to the tailback here. And you got a little flood route. The tight end's going to run a corner route. The fullback is going to run an arrow route or a flat route. And you'll see the outside linebacker pick up the arrow route, and you'll see Rock Yassin, our outstanding young sophomore corner, do a great job playing the ball, undercuts, knock the ball away. You'll get a good shot of it here in the end zone right here. You can see the closed formation by Central Michigan. I think it's Malik Ketchens there at outside linebacker, head up the tight end to your left. You'll see Rock kind of slide over.
You'll see the play action right there by Cooper Rush, their quarterback, and a little slight rollout trying to keep contained with our defensive end there, Kari Rozier and Jordan Guyton. You'll see Rock come over the top, do a nice job right in the hip pocket of the tight end, do a nice job on the ball right there. One more look at it. You'll see Rock here identify the play action, make a great play on the ball, and that's this week's edition of Coach's Corner.
Heck of a defensive play there against the Chippewas. And we had one last week against the Mocs as well, protecting that end zone. Let us go ahead and take our final timeout. When we come back, we'll take a look at the health of the Blue Hose with the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report and also our Chick-fil-A look ahead.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
It's bow time at Bojangles. And since 1977, we've been serving made-from-scratch biscuits all day, every day. Come in today and try one of our $4 breakfast biscuit combos with your choice of a bacon, egg, and cheese biscuit, country ham biscuit, sausage and egg biscuit, or steak biscuit. Every biscuit is made from scratch and served all day with your choice of fixin' and a drink. Four different combos, only $4 each. Available for a limited time. Bojangles, it's bow time.
Hi, this is Harold Nichols, head football coach here at Presbyterian College. Do you need some help simplifying your life? Matt Davis has helped me, and he can help you too. Go see Matt Davis and his great team at State Farm in Clinton, South Carolina. They will handle your auto, home, and life insurance so you will have more time to handle everything else in life. You could earn discounts up to 40%. Sounds like a touchdown to me.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Football is brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
We welcome you back to Inside Blue Hose Football, and Coach, again, knock on wood, I know we have a couple of dings, but nothing really major out there.
No, not right now. You know, we missed Jaycee Yeldell, the defensive end that got hurt against Central Michigan. He's going to be out for a significant amount of time. How much time, I'm not sure. Missed Zach Cooper, who got hurt during the week. I think we'll get him back. Coming out of the ball game, I don't think anything significant.
That's what I was leaning to.
You know, always trying to all these things that will pop up during the week. But I think overall, I think we're relatively healthy. Thanks to Dr. Milner and all the folks at Palmetto Bone and Joint.
How about our tight end, Perter?
I think he'll be able to get back this week. I really do.
Awesome.
You know, he made some good progress last week, knock on wood. And he, you know, we've really missed him here in his first couple weekends. So it'd be good to have him back.
All righty, now it's time to take a look at our Chick-fil-A next week's opponent.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Alrighty, Coach. This is a team, the Camels of Campbell. Everybody's talking about, will that be the next team? Will they go, you know, full scholarship and be the next team to bring their football team into the Big South Conference? This is a team that competed well here at Bailey Memorial, but ran into a very good effort by your Blue Hose. So they're going to be hungry to try to get some payback at home, I think.
Yeah, well, you know, they're a really, really good football team.
Yeah.
You know, I think they're averaging 56 points a game, you know. They've scored, I think, 60-something the first week and then 50-something the next week. So they're 2-0, got a lot of confidence. They've got a young kid, a redshirt freshman quarterback by the name of Burgess, who is a really, really good player. They've got two tailbacks that are really good. You know, the thing that really made a big impression on me last year about their football team was their front seven was really, really good in the box.
They're solid. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know, they're a very, very talented football team. So it'll be a big challenge for us on the road up there in Buies Creek. While I'm finishing up, I got to give a shout out to Kathy Poss, who is Coach Elliot Poss is my head coach's wife down in Elbert County, Georgia. She's down there listening to us, and she gave me a shout out the other day. So I want to say hello to Miss Kathy and appreciate her. But again, tough week this week against Campbell, no doubt.
No doubt about it. Well, Coach, thank you very much for joining us. Good luck against the Camels of Campbell. Mm-hmm. And this reminder, if you miss any of our shows this year, you can catch all of Inside Blue Hose Football on GoBlueHose.com. For the Coach Harold Nichols, I'm Eric Thacker. Till we see you again, Go Blue Hose.
Inside Blue Hose Football was brought to you by Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone and Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Bojangles, it's bow time. We would like to thank the following Blue Hose Honor Roll sponsors. The Bud Group. Good Times Entertainment. Carolina Concrete. Enterprise Rent-A-Car. Midway Barbecue. Hannah Heating and Air Conditioning. Epting Turf and Tractor. Arthur State Bank. Carolina Auto Sales of Clinton. Wilson's Cafe. Tony's Pizza and Steamer's Cafe.